and welcome back to the Nurse Nook. Today I have a really interesting video for you guys. We are going to be talking all about down there and all about feminine hygiene. I feel like as a nurse, this is a super important topic for me to touch on because there is not a whole lot of accurate information out there about feminine hygiene. And a lot of times social media kind of gives you the wrong information. And young girls are growing up thinking the wrong things about their feminine health. So I am here to kind of give you guys a little bit of the medical side and what I know and what I think is helpful to know as a woman. I'm not a medical doctor, so a lot of this is my own opinion and things that I have just learned throughout the years. So the first thing I'm gonna talk about, which seems to be a really hot topic, is discharge. Not too long ago, I saw this challenge on Twitter, and it was basically called, I think it was like the panty challenge or something like that. And basically, women were taking pictures of their underwear to show how little discharge they had. And I'm just thinking, what in the world is this? Because a lot of people don't know, discharge is healthy. Your vagina is supposed to produce discharge. It's weird if it doesn't, because discharge is basically your vagina cleaning itself. Now, if your discharge starts changing to where the odor gets really foul or the consistency is super thick, then that's a little bit more of a health concern. But normal, regular discharge is so normal, and everybody should be experiencing that. Discharge is part of the female reproductive cycle. During certain parts of your cycle, your discharge may increase, look a little bit different, increases during times like ovulation, when you're aroused, and it will continue even after your cycle is done, and it'll fluctuate throughout your entire cycle. That brings me to my next talking point, which is yeast infections and BV. If you guys don't know what BV is short for bacterial vaginosis, and these both are very, very common things that a lot of people experience, and there isn't a whole lot of education out there about it. So yeast infections and BV can be caused by pretty much almost anything. They can happen just naturally, especially if you're exposed to different sexual partners or new products that you're using down there. If your pH is off, these are some things that can happen to you. So for people that experience chronic, recurrent, or just sporadic yeast infections or BV, there's this really cool product that I found and actually did like a whole bunch of research on it. And it's something that could help prevent and also treat yeast infections as well as BV. Boric acid is something that has been used for over 100 years to treat vaginal infections. It's not only an antifungal, but it's also an antiviral. So it kind of helps combat both the yeast and the BV. And the one that I use is Boric Life by NutraBlast. And this is super cool because it comes, I'll show you guys, I'll take a little pill out. It comes basically like a little pill, like something that you would take like a vitamin. However, it's a suppository that you insert into your vagina. And the really cool thing about NutraBlast is their products also come with applicators. It comes with like a little applicator that's almost like a tampon inserter, but it's a lot smaller. You just put the pill in the top and you insert into your vagina. And another really cool thing that they offer is the pH strips. I think this is super, super cool. It comes like a little pH strip tester, and it has the like colors here, lets you know where you are. So basically you cut off a piece of the strip, you kind of insert it into your private areas, and it will test the pH and let you know if your pH balance is off, which is indicative of some kind of infectious process going on. And my absolute favorite thing about this company is they're super affordable. You can get them on Amazon. They're super easy to get to, quick shipping. Get it on Amazon, and there's tons and tons of reviews on Amazon of like other people that have tried it and their success stories. So I decided to try it for myself, and it has been amazing for me. I've heard such great things about this product. My homegirl Fatima, who's also another nurse YouTuber, uses this as well. Super awesome company. Definitely check them out. The link is going to be down below to order yours and try out this amazing product. It's affordable, it's safe, and it's a great alternative to some more traditional, more expensive remedies for this. So my next tip is going to be about washing and how to keep your lady parts clean. I will say this, I will lead with this. Please do not douche. That is so unhealthy for your vagina. I really don't know where that came from, where the douching idea came from, but it is really, really unhealthy for your vagina and throws like your pH out of whack and leads to a lot more problems. So please, no douching. However, you do want to keep your lady parts super, super clean. My advice to keep your lady parts clean is to use a very gentle soap with no dyes, whether that be Dove, Shea Moisture, whatever kind of natural soap or soap that doesn't have a lot of additives in it. Definitely sensitive skin soaps are awesome. I personally think bar soaps work better, but if you use a sensitive skin body wash, that's also fine too. I've heard this from tons and tons of gynecologists, so it's not just me. Soap does not belong inside of the vagina. So if you are gonna clean with soap, which I think most people aren't, as you should, clean the outer labias. Do not go inside of your actual vagina with the soap. This is also something that really can throw your pH balance off of whack and really start causing yeast infections. If you do use a washcloth, make sure that you're replacing it frequently. If you start using your washcloth too much for that area, you're gonna just start spreading more and more bacteria and you're just gonna have a never-ending bacteria growth there. So whatever it is you use to clean, make sure that it is clean and fresh and has not been used 5,000 times. Okay, so now moving into smell, how to make sure that your nether regions always smell the best. Believe it or not, diet has a huge, huge impact on the smell and secretions of your vagina. With that being said, there are a ton of things that you can eat to make your odor down there actually smell a lot better. Some of these things are gonna be things like fruits, pineapples, especially greens, kale is a huge one. Greek yogurt, citrus, cranberry juice, also a huge one. And believe it or not, I've also heard that garlic has a positive impact on the smell down there. Besides food, some things that you can also do to improve your scent down there is to not wear as many tight clothing or tight underwear. Cotton underwear are the best to wear because it's a lot more breathable and lets your vagina pretty much breathe freely. When you start wearing really, really tight pants or clothing, it kind of just makes everything kind of just like and can't breathe and just the bacteria just grows and it's a moist environment and there's nowhere for the air to go down there, so everything just starts mustering and it's a whole big, you don't even want to. Yeah. Also, another tip is not reusing your panties. And you would be surprised how many people actually do this. I always say if you wear it for at least an hour, do not put them back on, put them in the wash and get a fresh pair. Especially if you sweat in them. If you like went to the gym for an hour, you sweated, you like did whatever, and you figured, oh, I only wore these underwear for an hour, let me put them back on. Please do not put them back on. Please get a fresh pair because that also would contribute to bacterial growth down there. So my last tip, I'm just gonna kind of throw a couple things out there. I couldn't find one tip that I just had my heart set on, so I kind of wanted to share a little bit of the important ones I wanted to sneak in here. One of the really important ones I want to share is how to wipe. Always wipe front to back. You never want to wipe back to front because you are taking, by wiping back to front, so toward your rectum to the top of your vagina, that is wiping back to front. You want to wipe from vagina to rectum. That is because if you wipe back to front, you are taking the bacteria that is from your rectum and wiping it into your vagina, and that bacteria is living in there and creating more bacteria. Another tip is to get checked frequently at the gynecologist. You should be visiting the gynecologist regularly and making sure that your feminine health is okay. Along with visiting the gynecologist, if you are somebody that is sexually active, please, please, please be using protection. That is also not only to defend against STDs, but also to defend against a lot of bacteria that come from sexual intercourse that could be causing things like yeast infections and BV. But also super, super important to be getting tested for STDs because there are STDs out there that not only affect your health down there, but can also affect things like your fertility. And that is something that you do not want to get into. So take care of your cooter, eat your fruits, get checked regularly, visit the gynecologist regularly. Keep it clean, keep it fresh, wipe front to back, and change your panties. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you took something away from this and learned a little something. Again, don't forget to check out the NutraBlast Boric Life suppositories. It'll be linked down below. Thank you all so much for watching, and I love you guys.